Everyone, welcome!
Hi, I'm Sasha Ottey, Executive Director of PCOS Challenge, the National Polycystic Ovary Syndrome Association based in the United States of America. I'm excited to be here in India for the first PCOS International Conference with both patients and healthcare providers, learning from each other, learning about the importance of prioritizing PCOS.
Hi, my name is Maria Palmetun Ekbäck. I'm from Sweden. I'm here on this international course, PCO course. It's the first time in India because I want to talk about hirsutism and how it affects quality of life. So why is it important to treat hirsutism? The most important thing is because it has so big impact on quality of life, very negative impact on quality of life.
I am Dr. Felice Kirsch, and I am here in beautiful Kerala, India, to attend and to speak at the first ever conference on PCOS to be held in India. And I am here because I am on a mission, both a personal mission and a professional mission, to educate and spread knowledge about PCOS.
I'm here today in the International Conference on PCOS. As a psychologist, as a practitioner, and as a professor of psychology, my feeling is this. Today's conference is a very, very relevant one for our population, for Indian population, current population, important for our youngsters. So I'm very happy that conducting a session talk about emotional wellness among adolescent and women who are having PCOS.
I'm Dr. Kanthi Bansal from Ahmedabad. Actually, I'm here. This is the first international conference both for doctors and public awareness for patients as well. And it so happened that I met Sasha Ottey, who is one of the organizers of this conference. I truly feel that it's a wonderful conference to be at, and I'm very thankful to Sasha for informing me, and equally thankful to Dr. Anita for inviting me.
I'm Megha Khatri, and today I've come to this conference on PCOS. So I was basically called here because personally I knew Anita ma'am, and also because she came to know about my story regarding me having PCOS before and how I overcame that. Actually, I am a Latin dancer by profession, and I would suggest people that take care of yourself, take care of your body, exercise, rest well, eat well. The more you feed it well, the more it's going to give it back to you.
And I am a nutritionist practicing in Mumbai, and therefore I have a deep interest in understanding and letting people helping people understand how nutrition and exercise can play a role in management of polycystic ovarian syndrome.
Hi, I'm Dr. Anushree Patil. I'm representing Indian Council of Medical Research and National Institute for Research in Reproductive Health at this conference. When Dr. Anita Mani invited me for this conference, I was really happy about the initiative which they have taken in this area. And what excited me the most was the patient education program which they were going to have in this conference along with the routine conference.
I'm Dr. Elizabeth Jacob from Little Flower Hospital and Research Center, Angamali. The PCOS Challenge Group has been very interactive and extremely research oriented, and their interest in bringing change to the women's life who are suffering from PCOD has been a great eye-opener to me in particular.
Hi, this is Arunima Gupta. I'm a contemporary dancer and a Zumba instructor. The first thing what you can do is basically start exercising. However it could be a walk, it could be a jog, it could be going for a swimming class or maybe a yoga class, dance class, or to the gym, however it can be. But what I know from my own experience is the most, you know, enjoyable form of exercise is Zumba. Because Zumba has a lot of song, dance, sequence. It's totally non-judgmental. If you go to a dance class, you're supposed to perform. You're supposed to take your skill from one level to another level. And that gives you mental pressure because you're again competing against something. But if you go to a Zumba class, there is nothing like that. You just go enjoy the music and just dance your heart out.